feet on down, amen, there was a certain, amen, the disciple. And the Lord said unto him, arise and go into the street which is called Straight Street. One Lord, one faith, and one baptism. Only one way to God, and that's the straight way. That's the street of strength. I mean, you got to walk uprightly before the Lord. You got to be holy, for God said, I am holy, and I'm going to have me a holy people, and they're going to serve me in holiness.
Hallelujah.
No other way. Straight. Hallelujah. Is the gate. Amen. To heaven. A few will be there that will find it. Because of all the detours set along the way. Have you ever been on the highway? And I believe Minister Helen Dewberry spoke that tonight. Talking about there was a detour. And so she took another route. There's some detours in our lives, saints of God. But don't let it twist you. Don't get confused about it. God will give you another way to get to where you need to get. God will give you another way to see your family coming out. God will turn that thing around, reverse that thing. And sometimes those detours is okay.
Yes.
Amen.
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 You didn't plan it. You can't plan your life. So you got to be able to be flexible to let God do the detour. Because if you would have kept going straight, something else may have came. So God will detour that thing. He'll switch it up on you to be able to let you understand that I'm nothing without him. But I can do all things through him. And I'm able to stand in the midst of the storm. I'm able to go through it. I'm able to trust in the Lord. I know that God said, I'll be with you, never leave you. And Lord, forever will I be with you till the end. That's the kind of God you serve. And the Lord said unto them, arise and go into the street, which is called Straight Street, and inquire in the house, amen, of Judas, the one called Saul of Tarsus. And behold, he began to pray. Somebody said, you got to pray. So I believe there was something that said you got to fast, and then you got to pray, and there's an assignment, and there's a call on your life. So now you're getting the order, you're getting the charge, that you're not just here, amen, just because you want to be saved. It's because God assigned you to get the job done. There's a call on your life. The power of the Holy Ghost will give you the equipment to be able to assign yourself and do what God so required of you to do. And he had a vision, and a man named Ananias coming in and putting his hand on him that he might receive his sight. Now we're talking about Saul now. Amen. And Ananias answered the Lord, amen, have heard by many, amen, of this man, amen, he's evil. But yet Ananias still determined to carry out the assignment. And that let us know that don't back up against the devil. Don't back up when he come against you. Don't back up, because greater is he that is in me than he that's in the world. Don't back up, saints.
All right.
Amen. Let God be God before you.
Amen.
It said, if God be for me, who can be against me?
Word. Amen. All right. That's the word.
Hallelujah, Ananias. Amen. Amen. He said, this is an evil man. You've done to the saints at Jerusalem many and cruel things. And here he have authority from the chief priests to bind all them that call on the name. You're talking about the name of Jesus. So if they were going through then when you begin to call on the name of Jesus, saints, there's a war going on because there's power in that name. And the enemy don't like that name. So he's going to come against you in every way that he can. But you keep calling Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. There's power in that name.
All right.
Hallelujah. Oh, my God. But the Lord said unto him, go thy way, for he is a chosen vessel unto me, and bear my name before the Gentiles and the kings and the children of Israel. I will show him how great things he must suffer. Somebody say suffer. Anybody trying to hear that?
Amen.
Amen. Suffer Amen. For my name's sake. But it is what it is.
That's right.
There is a struggle.
Amen.
There's suffering. Yes. It says, they that suffer with me shall reign with me. So there is a part of this walk that you're going to suffer some things. You're going to go through some things that are so painful that you think you're not going to be able to live. But God said not so. I believe the Bible said you shall live and not die. Why? To declare the works of the Lord.
All right.
The name. To proclaim the the name of Jesus to give you the authority to speak against the enemy, lay hands on the sick that they will recover, to give sight to the blind. You have the authority by the power of the Holy Ghost. Walk therein under the anointing of God. Ananias went his way and entered into the house, and putting his hand on him said, Brother Saul. Hallelujah, somebody. He called him brother. Brother Saul. Saints of God, you may see your family members. You may see, amen, your neighbors, or you may see somebody that, amen, they don't even look like they're thinking about being saved. But you begin to speak over them like brother, sister, evangelist, prophet. Amen. You began to say, you are saved. You are delivered. You are healed. You may not, you don't even see that. But you see it in the spiritual.
Amen. Real. Amen. Amen.
Oh my God. You see it in the spiritual realm.
Amen.
And you begin to operate in that.
Yes, ma'am.
Because we're spiritual beings.
Yeah.
And when you begin to recognize who you really are, you begin to stand firm on what you know that you know that you know, then you're able, amen, to be able to stand firm and be able to, amen, call those things that were not as though they were. You speak it into the atmosphere. God just spoke the word and things came. Speak out, amen, the glory of the Lord, and let the power of God have its way. And Ananias went his way and entered into the house, putting his hand on him and said, Brother Saul. And the Lord, even Jesus, appeared unto him in the way as they came it, has set him that thou mightest receive thy sight. Now comes his healing. See, there's a healing in the midst of all of that, see.
Right.
You see, he had to go through a many trials, a many tribulations, persecution, situations, ridiculed and talked about and laughed at and scorned and made fun of. How many of you are talking about, amen, bullies in school? There's bullies on jobs. There's grown folk acting like a bunch of kids, trying to bully somebody. I had some bullies a few years ago. Amen. I'm like, why do this at? And I'm all like, the devil is a liar. Hallelujah. I went before the Lord. I said, Lord, keep my feet stood on the ground of the word of God, huh? Because God, I know there's something in this for me, and I know that the glory of the Lord shall be revealed. Here we are in our 50s, almost 60, and I got, amen, folk hating on me. I ain't even did anything. I let us know that they will mess with you.
Well, well.
My God, but you got to stand on God's word, irregardless. Hallelujah, because you say, I'm royal. I'm holy. I'm righteous. I am chosen. Hallelujah. And I don't expect everybody to like that.
That's all right.
But you stand firm on that.
Amen.
Because you are great in the sight of God.
Hallelujah.
And immediately after they fell, amen, he said, amen. And he came and he laid hands on him. And he said, you'll be filled with the Holy Ghost. Somebody say, Holy Ghost.
Holy Ghost.
And immediately there fell from his eyes that it had been scales. And he received sight forthwith and arose and was baptized. Somebody say baptized.
Baptist.
Did you hear what I'm saying? There's power, authority, speaking the thing, seeing the move of God. Talks about the operation, the receiving, amen, of the power of God. You go to the hospital and they begin to do an operation. There's a scar here and there's a something there. There's a poke there. But when God do the operation in your life, when God do it, it's nothing left. It's not a scar, but the power of God is resonating in your inner being. And now you're able to look back over your life and think about what God has already brought you out of. How many of you, if you don't even believe where you are today because you're in a situation that you didn't see your way out.
Yes, ma'am.
You were in poverty and didn't see that.
Amen.
Couldn't imagine that you living like this, or you on a job like that, or you driving this, or you in college at this college, this elite college, or you somewhere where others are looking back and saying, why is she here? Why is he here? It's because I'm chosen.
Chosen.
My God, and I've got favor.
Amen.
Hallelujah, God.
Thank you, Lord.
Yeah.
His power in his word.
Yeah.
There's authority. You've got to stand firm, people of God.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you.